In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. On the day of her baptism, your mother, your nonna, Italia, was welcomed into the church. She was given new life in Jesus Christ and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today we greet the body of our sister, and we surround her with the church's prayer. We commend our sister Italia to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made in her baptism may now be fulfilled. Once again, good afternoon, and as most of you now know, I'm Father Ian Ryswick, and I have the privilege for the past 5 years of being with your mother, with your Nona, at Marianne Home. I am the chaplain to the Missionary Sisters of the Precious Blood, and where your mother has been living for the past 5 years. And as I will share with you, we've experienced some amazing experiences with your mother, which have brought much consolation, I hope, to the family. And for us, Sister Tekla and myself in particular, a great reminder of the giftedness of the love and the mercy of God. The questions that we may not always understand, but your mother certainly knew that she was loved by her family, and she had great trust and love in God. And so we come together today to renew our trust in Jesus Christ, who by dying upon the cross has freed us from death, and by rising from the dead has opened the gates of heaven. Let us pray for your mother, our sister Italia, that she may share in Christ's victory. Let us pray also for ourselves, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you have been our refuge and our strength. Before the mountains were born, or the earth came to be, you are God. Have mercy now on your servant Italia, whose long life was spent in your service. Give her a place in your kingdom, where hope is firm for all who love, and rest is sure for all who serve. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Death came through one man, and in the same way, the resurrection of the dead has come through one man. Just as all people died in Adam, so all people will be brought to life in Jesus Christ. But all of them in their proper order, Christ as the first fruits, and then coming after Christ, those who belong to him. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response is, I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. How gracious is the Lord and just. Our God has compassion. The Lord protects the simple hearts. I was helpless, so God saved me. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I trusted even when I said, I am sorely afflicted. And when I said in my alarm, there is no one I can trust. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. O precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On arriving at Bethany, Jesus found that Lazarus had been in the tomb for 4 days already. Bethany is only about 2 miles from Jerusalem. And many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to sympathize with them over their brother. When Martha heard that it was Jesus that had come, she went out to meet him. Mary remained seated in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, God will grant you." "Your brother," said Mary to her, said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection from the dead." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though they die, they will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So as I said, for the last 5 years, I have had that privilege of getting to know Italia and getting to know in particular, of course, Anna and Lara as they came to visit their Nona, their mother. And I didn't know her as that young, wonderful looking woman who was the designer, who had her own boutique, who was a very independent woman, who lived a very wonderful life, who designed and loved to make things for people, for her family in particular. I'm sure your wedding gown was probably made. All that, yours wedding gown was made by your, you know, those are things that are important and things that you remember. And of course, she had, of course, had to say goodbye in 1999 to your father. To be a widow for that long is a very difficult situation. And then to be burdened with the cross of dementia. And yet, she carried that cross. And as a family, you supported her. You wanted her to be with you as long as possible. And even after 7 long years, when you finally had to bring her to Marianne home, it wasn't because you didn't love her. It's because you recognized now she needed extra care. And your love for her was still there. One of the things that I've learned after being at Marianne Home for 12 years, many people get absolutely no visitors. Some people get one or two. You probably saw that yourself. Your mother was blessed. Even though she wasn't able to communicate, she always had somebody there. The sisters always went in her room every single day. They prayed with her. Once a month, I would anoint her. The last time I anointed before the pandemic was Ash Wednesday, 2020. And I walked into your mother's room, as I always do, and I always greeted her. Even though she wasn't able to respond, I always treated her with the same respect and dignity that I did to every person. And I said, "Buongiorno, Italia. Come sta?" And then I put my hand on her and I said, "In nomine Padre, de Filio e Spirito Santo." And her eyes opened. And then I anointed her and she smiled. Sister Tecla was in tears because for so long she had never responded. And then I anointed her again on Christmas Day this year. Again, the same thing happened. Her eyes opened. When Sister Tecla called last week to say, "We think Italia is going," she asked me to pray with her on the telephone. And again, your mother's eyes opened. We don't understand everything, but we have to believe that God had a plan. And perhaps God's plan was for your mother to be a witness, not only to you, her loving family, but to so many countless people. She brought such strength to so many staff members when they saw how much you loved her and constantly came to see her. Because for many of the staff, they had to deal with people who had no one come to see them. Your mother was surrounded by love. As I said, that nice little blue mat in front of her bed, it was there so she wouldn't fall, but it was also there for comfort. And that's what we're celebrating. We don't understand why she was given that cross for so long. But what we do know is that she has received the reward of everlasting life. She had strong faith. She must have. Because even though everything else was gone, when she heard those words from her native language, she must have known something. So we believe. Henry Van Dyke wrote a story about death as a ship setting sail. Your parents set sail from England to Toronto. Of course, they came from Italy to Wales, which is an odd place to go. But then again, that allowed you, Anna, to be Welsh. And I hope you can speak Welsh. You can't speak a word of Welsh with all those consonants together? If you've ever seen, have you ever tried to figure out Welsh? It's an unbelievable language. I don't know how they speak it. My mother's from Scotland where they speak Gaelic, but that's completely different. At least you Italians, you might be able to understand one another, even though different dialects from different regions. But the one thing your mother understood was the message of love. And I believe she would have understood that the story of Henry Van Dyke, who describes death as a ship departing from one port and arriving in another. And that's what we believe. We believe life begins at conception, but at death it is not the end, but a new beginning. And so Henry Van Dyke writes this, and I've shared this story many times, beginning at the funeral of my own father. "I'm standing upon a seashore. A ship at my side spreads her white sails to the morning breeze and starts out for the ocean. She's an object of beauty and strength. And at length I stand and I watch her until at length she's only a ribbon of white cloud just where the sea and the sky come to mingle with each other. Then someone at my side there says, 'There, she's gone.' 'Gone where?' 'Gone from my sight, that is all. She's just as large in mast and hull and spar as she was when she left my side, and just as able to bear her load of living freight to her place of destination. Her diminished size is in me, not in her. And just at that moment, when someone at my side says, there, she's gone, there are heavenly voices ready to say, there, she comes. And that's dying. I'm sure the first person who said, there she comes, was your father, as he welcomed her home. And perhaps he said, what took you so long? And in her clear vision, she said, I had a few things I had to take care of. I'd now invite Lara to come forward and have the difficult job of doing the eulogy that her cousin was unable to do for her. You can take your masks off.
You left me on a sad note.
I know, sorry.
Okay. Our parents give us life. Our grandparents give us a sense of who we are and where we came from. Nonna's passion for her Italian culture gave her her zest in life, which was rooted from her warm upbringing. Her legacy lives on within each of us. Nonna Italia loved us all deeply and fully. She never hesitated to demonstrate that through her generous acts of love and kind words of encouragement. She was a friend and confidant to many, a truly elegant woman inside and out. She had a smile that was a ray of sunshine and an unforgettable presence. Nonna's effortlessly classic style was ahead of its time. She also had a curious nature, which enriched her life with worldly knowledge, an entrepreneurial spirit, and a love for the arts, including opera, fashion, and culinary. Okay. Nonna taught me this song when I was 2 years old. Mamma son tanto felice perché ritorno da te. La mia canzone ti dice che il più bel giorno per me. Mamma son tanto felice vivere lontano perché. Mamma, solo per te la mia canzone vola. Mamma, sarai con me, tu non sarai più sola. Quanto ti voglio bene, queste parole d'amore che ti sospira il mio cuore, forse non usano più, mamma, ma la canzone mia più bella sei tu la vita e per la vita non ti lascio mai più. I reference this song not only because it brings back fond memories of Nonna teaching me about music and the Italian language, but because I hope it reminds us all that love comes in many forms and from different sources. Nonna Italia made us all feel her motherly love, and may we all hold her dear in our hearts and feel and spread her care and compassionate love forever.
You are the one that holds me. You are the one that holds me.
Thank you, Lara. That was beautiful. I was thinking that one of the things that I remember in your mom's room when we had Canada Day one year, a couple of years ago, we put little Canadian flags in, over your mom's bed, and we stuck an Italian sticker on there. But had we only known about Wales, I could have got, you know, we could have put a dragon there, you know, from Wales. My brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and now sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for our church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his, and our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Italia was given the pledge of eternal life. May she now be admitted into the company of saints. Let us pray to the Lord. Italia was nourished and refreshed at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us, now await the kingdom. As we remember Italia's beloved husband, Pietro, her parents, Celeste and Rosaria, and all her departed loved ones, grant them an everlasting home with your son. Let us pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of your mother, your Nonna, your children, her children, Anna and Franco, her grandchildren, Jean-Pierre and his wife, Lisa, Carlo and Laura, and her great-grandson, Gabriel, Teresa Saracini, and all her extended family and friends who seek consolation from the Lord Jesus, who wept at the tomb of his friend Lazarus. Let us pray to the Lord. We ask God's blessing on all those who are seriously ill. Be close to them in their time of need, and if it be your will, heal them and restore them to the fullness of health. Let us pray to the Lord. Remember all those who are continuing to struggle during these long days of COVID, and which for so many has been difficult, especially the elderly. May they, as your mother did, always know the love of family and friends. Let us pray to the Lord. Today we are saddened by the loss of a loving mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, Zia, and friend, who was always loving and caring, hardworking, kind, and generous, and whom we remember today with love. May our hope in the resurrection and the promise of eternal life bring us comfort and turn our sadness into joy. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all of us who are gathered here today to worship in faith, hope, and love, those here gathered in the chapel, and all those who are joining us in the various means of communication, in particular through prayer, that we all may be gathered together into God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. Loving God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We are a family, and as a family, we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for our sister Italia. And now comes our last farewell. There will be sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall joyfully greet her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this community may disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again into the joys of God's kingdom. Let us therefore console each other in our faith in Jesus Christ. In baptism, your mother, your Nonna, shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Italia in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the many blessings you bestowed upon Italia in this life, for they are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Jesus Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and with our sister forever. My dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. Italia, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to that holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
This just completes our service this afternoon here. We're now going to be making our way to the Queen of Heaven Mausoleum or Cemetery, and that is on 27 Highway, just a little bit north of the 407. And we are going to be taking the 407 today, so when we exit from our driveway, we'll proceed south on Young Street to the 407 Highway, and then west on the 407 to Highway 27. We'd ask you to drive with caution. I'll try not to lose you. I'm going to be leading, and we'll try not to lose you, but we'll certainly wait for you at the cemetery to catch up. Now, I know some of you have been asked to be pallbearers. If you could make your way to the back of the chapel, please, to where Christine is, we'll bring Italia's casket back to you. Thank you.
Just right here.